Hello and good afternoon or good morning, depending on where you may be. My name is Matt Hiscock and I am the Head of Product Science and Solutions here at Oxford Instruments Nano Analysis. And I'd like to welcome you to this brief tutorial on performing GSR analysis with AZtecGSR. As you can see, I'm broadcasting from our head office in High Wycombe in the UK, and you can see that I'm sat here at the microscope. So what are we going to cover today? Well, let's start off with some contents. First, we'll go through kind of a brief overview of what GSR analysis is. I'm sure that's going to be familiar to many of you. We will then look at Oxford Instruments history with gunshot residue. It goes back quite a long way. And we'll look at the AZtec GSR product, what it is, and then we'll look at how it interacts with analytical hardware. We'll then have a look at just a few of the many opportunities we have for optimizing our GSR analysis workflow. And then we will move on to a live demonstration here on the microscope. Finally, I'll draw just a few conclusions and then we'll go to a question and answer session. Now, if you have questions throughout the webinar, please do not hesitate to enter them in the interface. You should have a questions tab on the GoToMeeting setup that you can enter your questions in. I will endeavour, of course, to try and answer all of the questions, but if I'm not able to due to time restraints, then I will get back to you individually. Right, so let's get going. So firstly, what is GSR analysis? What are we talking about here? Well, as I'm sure we all know, GSR is gunshot residue. And gunshot residue is formed when a bullet is fired from a gun and particles are formed from the condensation of the vapor, which is the combusted remnants that include the bullet primer. These particles will condense and have a typically characteristic composition depending on the type of ammunition that has been used, and are often spherical in a size range from about half a micron up to a few microns. These GSR gunshot residue particles may land on the shooter as well as on anyone else who's immediately present, and can then be collected by law enforcement agencies and then analyzed in terms of their composition and morphology to provide a form of forensic evidence that can potentially be presented in a court of law. So given the seriousness attached to this form of evidence, well, what do we need from any system that is going to be used to acquire data on it? Well, firstly, we need to obtain chemical information alongside morphological information from any candidate particles that we think could be GSR. And for that reason, we're going to perform the analysis with a scanning electron microscope and with an associated analytical system. We need to ideally be able to identify the type of GSR and associate it with the ammunition type. So if that's a standard lead bearing ammunition or perhaps a lead free ammunition. We need to be able to classify any particles that we find according to published rules, such as those found in ASTM E1588. We're going to need to be able to do this quickly. More often than not, there are more samples and more work to do than we have time for. So we want to be as efficient as possible in our analysis whilst critically maintaining quality. Therefore, we want our analysis to be able to be run automatically, so perhaps overnight, making the best possible use of our machine time. And we want it to be able to perform a manual reacquisition, reanalysis of the data that ultimately we would like to present to a court. And fundamentally, this data must be high quality and reproducible. So let's have a quick look at our history with GSR analysis here at Oxford Instruments. Well, it starts all the way back in 1988 with the AN10000 system. And we've been working with GSR since then and have implemented analysis systems for it in each of our subsequent analytical platforms. In 2015, we first released gunshot residue analysis in our AZtec platform, our current generation platform. And since then, we have been updating it, both in terms of the functionality within it on the basis of customer feedback, and also to include the latest classification schemes, for example, from ASTM E1588. The world map there, everything in blue is countries that have got AZtec GSR installed, so quite a wide coverage, and then a wide network of applications and support staff, all of whom are able to support it. So, well, what is AZtec GSR? Well, it's a number of different things, and I've expressed it in a few different ways here to try and answer that question. Firstly and foremost, it is a specific implementation of the AZtec feature particle analysis platform, which is optimized for the analysis of GSR. It automates the detection, measurement, and classification of candidate GSR particles, and then includes workflows for both reacquisition and confirmation of those particles. As I said before, it's scanning electron microscope based, and the analytical technique we use to measure the composition is energy dispersive X-ray spectrometry, EDS. So essentially, it's this customized recipe for AZtec feature, and it includes classification according to ASTM E1588, the 2016, 2017, and 2020 versions of that document. In order to ensure quality and reliability in terms of the measurement of composition, it includes our true Q spectrum processing, which I will talk about in a lot more detail in a moment, but which is there to ensure that we identify the elements correctly and are able to quantify compositions correctly. And as I've alluded to, throughout the years, we've added various different optimizations to enhance things like throughput, to be able to allow us to deal with multiple runs at once, and also to allow us to focus our analysis time where it is needed most. Finally, it also includes capability to run reacquisitions. So let's just have a look at the analytical hardware that we use with AZtec GSR. Now, AZtec GSR, I guess, as we mostly think of it, is the software, but also attached to it is electronics and a detector, such as the one that you can see in the background over here. And that system together is what makes the whole product. Now, we use Oxford Instruments' latest generation Ultimax or Explore silicon drift detectors to measure the composition of any particles that we may find. Now, these detectors are designed to have large sensor sizes. The Ultimax range, for example, has sensor sizes of 40, 65, 100 or 170 square millimeters. And the reason why we make these detectors with large sensor sizes is that by having a large sensor, we can capture more of the X-rays that are emitted when the electron beam in the electron microscope hits the sample. And by capturing more of those per second, what we can do is reach our target number of counts that we would like to have in a spectrum, something like 20 to 30,000 in a shorter time period. And that means that we can then work at higher throughput rates because we're spending less time analyzing each particle. Of course, we can work in a converse way where we could say, well, actually, I'm going to work with my big detector for the same time as I would have used for a small detector, but get far more data in that time and therefore get a far better, higher quality measurement of the composition of the particles. So, as I briefly mentioned, we have various opportunities where we can optimize the workflow that we're going to use for this analysis. Now, this diagram here gives an overview of the various different places where we can optimize a workflow. But first, let's talk about what that workflow is. Essentially, what we need to do is three things. We need to set up our analysis, we need to run the analysis, and then we want to get our data out at the end. Now, in terms of setting up analysis, well, that could include things like setting up how we want to detect our particles, how we want to perform our EDS analysis, our compositional analysis. It could involve setting up a classification scheme, and then the places where we actually want to do our analysis. Well, the good news is that with AZtecGSR, we've set up the vast majority of that for you. So the particle detection, EDS analysis, and classification scheme are all there. So we don't need to address that. So immediately we're increasing our throughput, increasing, by decreasing our time from turning on the system to getting a result by having everything set up for us in advance. So actually, all we really need to do, and I'll do this as part of the live demonstration later, is set up where we want to analyze and ensure that we've got the correct conditions coming from our microscope. We can then start to run, and then we go through a process which is repeated for every single field of the field of view of the large area covering our sample. And in that process, we detect where features are, where candidate GSR particles are. We measure their morphology, we acquire EDS data from them, we quantify that data, and we classify that. And all of that is done automatically and can be done unattended whilst the system is running. And then when all the runs are complete, well, we can look at our data. So let's look at a few opportunities where we can make some optimizations to this workflow. The first is that we typically actually are more interested in getting data from some particles than others. Now, one of the places where we can do this that's particularly relevant to gunshot residue particles is if we were to perform a very fast analysis of every single particle that is there, we can decide on the basis of that fast analysis if actually we'd like a little bit more data. So one of the things we can do is, after that very quick initial analysis, say what class would a particle fall into? And we could say, well, if it falls into a class that would be described as consistent with gunshot residue, then we could say, well, actually, let's acquire a bit more data from those particles to see with additional X-ray counts, does it fall into the characteristic class? Can we detect any additional elements? We perhaps wouldn't choose to do that with particles which are immediately in a characteristic class because, well, we've already got enough evidence to show that. And we might not choose to do it with something which would be more of an environmental type particle because, well, we haven't got any elements of interest there. So essentially what we're doing is automatically focusing our analysis time where it's needed most. A second opportunity for optimization that we have in AZtecGSR is the ability to deal with multiple runs at once. Quite often, we might have multiple areas that are from the different stubs that have been collected from a suspect that we want to analyze. And rather than perhaps tweaking our recipes individually for each of those stubs, well, we could manage them all together at once by using this bulk editing or batch editing functionality that we have in AZtec. The next thing I want to show you is about an optimization which is not in the kind of setup process as I have shown so far, but actually during the run. And I'm going to show it to you with a sample which is not a GSR sample. And the reason for that is I'm going to show you something very, very fast, and I want it to display well on your screen. So actually I'm going to show you something from your geological sample, but what I'm going to show is completely relevant to GSR analysis. And that is this. We have recently implemented some improvements to the way that we communicate on where to go and get EDS compositional data from. And what you can see on this geological sample here is on the right, well, that was how our system runs now. We're able to acquire data from 258 features in just 10 seconds. Whereas prior to our recent upgrade, it would take us 77 seconds to do the same job. Now, the key point here is that both those data sets were acquired with exactly the same amount of data acquired per particle. So it's the same quality analysis, but nowadays we can just make it so much quicker than we could before. And that is a direct time saving in a GSR run, entirely based upon the EDS analysis. Moving on, I mentioned earlier that accuracy is of critical importance for gunshot residue analysis. And I mentioned that we apply a series of algorithms that we call TrueQ to all of our analyses that we do automatically. The reason we do that is that, well, performing a manual analysis of every single particle that we are interested in, which we detect automatically, would be incredibly laborious and just not practical when potentially we've got thousands of particles to look at. We would have to process each spectrum individually. We'd have to identify all of the elements that are present. We would have to determine how many counts have come from each element. We'd need to measure standards, and we'd need to account for various different physical effects, such as the matrix of the sample. It's just not practical. So what we do instead is use this collection of algorithms called TrueQ to go from this this raw spectrum here to something where we have identified all of the elements reliably and worked out the composition of the particle. And without going into too much detail, we've got various different algorithms which will run to do things like correct for the background, to correct for any times multiple x-rays arrive at the same time, to identify the elements and to correct for any matrix effects that we may have in the sample. It's absolutely critical, and I can't emphasize enough how important this is to the quality of the data that we acquire. And then in terms of quantifying, well, going from the raw counts associated with each element through to a result that we can actually use, well, the vast majority of the time for automated particle analysis, we use what's called, generally referred to as a standardless approach. Of course, it isn't standardless at all. It's an approach where we use standards that have been recorded by an expert right here at our factory in High Wycombe to ensure that you've got the highest quality data to use for your analysis. So, I've spoken about it for quite a long time. Let's now move over to a brief live demonstration. And what I'm going to do is open up AZtec just here, and you can see that the I have got my gunshot residue analysis profile already loaded. So this has loaded all of the settings that I need to perform my analysis. And right now I've got the microscope looking at a cobalt sample, and I can see that I've got a really nice beam set up there. So what I'm going to go and do is go and set up the contrast and brightness that I'm going to get from the microscope and use for my analysis. So I'm looking at an imaging standard which is shipped with AZtecGSR, and we're just going to reduce the magnification so we can see all of the elements that are present on it, and just move it over a touch. There we go, that should be fine. What I need to try and do is get the this rhodium here up to the top, and this cobalt roundabout here. So I need to make a couple of adjustments to the contrast and brightness on the microscope. I'm going to need a higher level of contrast and drop the brightness a bit. There we go. Getting close, little more contrast. Drop the brightness again. And that's fairly close to where I want it to be. Obviously, I'm doing this very, very quickly for the basis of this this demonstration. But once I've done that, I'm now essentially ready to go. I could, if I wanted, go and test my analysis on a single field. I could go and look at all of my settings, but they've been loaded for me as part of the GSR recipe. So what I'm going to do is go straight to my run step here. I'm going to hit this automate button, and I'm going to load the area where I want to do my analysis. I'm going to run over a known sample to check that my system is working well, and then I'm going to run over a sample from a suspect as well. Just going to hit my finish button. Yes, I want to run just here. This is a little safety check. And that's it. I'm ready to go. Hit the run button. And at this point, I could leave the system to do its work, and then I can come back at a later stage to look at the data as acquired. Now, of course, I'm not going to make you wait whilst that happens. I did acquire a little bit of data earlier on, which we can have a brief look at now. So let's just stop that run, and I'm going to jump over here to review some data, and we will go to this sample here, and I'm going to filter the data here to just look at particles which have initially been identified as characteristic, and there's just one here. So let's investigate that a bit further and actually do a reacquisition of that data. So I'm going to hit this start button. The microscope stage is now driving over to have a look at that particle, and when it gets there, it's released control to me here. So I'm going to collect a new image of this particle. Now it's relatively faint. In fact, I think what I might do is increase the magnification on it in this case, and increase the brightness. I've got full freedom to kind of play with this as I wish. Now, once again, I'm doing this very quickly because we're working live, but I would typically take a lot of care here to get a really good quality image. So I'll get another image now to work with. There we go. That will then be thresholded to select it. Once again, I can tweak that thresholding if I wish. There we go. And when I'm happy with how I've selected it, I could choose to reacquire data from that particle. That is happening right now. I think I've got a 5-second spectrum acquiring, so really high quality data. And you can see that compositional measurement here, and you can see that it's been characterized as characteristic. That's my reacquisition done. I could go on to more particles to look at if I wish. And then I can go through a confirmation routine where I can really have a look at all of the different peaks that are here until I'm really happy that this particle is in fact GSR. And if I were, I would just hit this confirm button. We can see all confirmed, and that's it. We have got an analysis complete. So really quite a straightforward workflow, and we could then go on to report on that data. With that, I'll move back to the presentation and just draw a few conclusions. Fundamentally, all I want to say is this: AZtecGSR is a customized version of the industry-leading AZtec feature particle analysis platform that is optimized for GSR analysis. And it's the combination of the latest generation hardware that you can see on the microscope up here, the electronics processing, which is behind the microscope, and then the software, which I have been showing you, which allows us to achieve very high levels of accuracy, speed, and reliability. We've got various key functionalities that we have built into the product to help the user along the way to be intelligent and smart about how they perform their analysis, and also to make life more convenient. With that, I will thank you very much for your time, and say good evening, or have a good rest of the day, depending on where you are. And thank you very much for attending. Goodbye.